Hello everyone, this is the EC251 class, that is Introduction to Electronics. Today the topic is clipper circuit. Now clipper circuit means a circuit which have the capability of cutting some portion. That means it act like a scissor. So it cuts some portion of a waveform. Suppose some waveform is given as input. Now we will see how a particular circuit can operate on that waveform so that some particular portion of that input waveform is cut or destroyed or vanished, we can say. So we will have some input. It will pass through a particular circuit which is called clipper circuit, and the output is some particular portion which we want. That portion will be cut, that portion will not be present in output. That is called clipper circuit. This is a application of diode. That means by using the property of diode we can have this application, that is cutting some portion of a particular waveform. So we will start with having the waveform of input as sinusoidal. So sinusoidal waveform will be in input, that is positive half cycle and negative half cycle equal, that will be in our input, and our output particular some portion either in positive or in negative, particular some portion will be cut. We will see in details how this operation is to be done. Okay, so we will start our lesson with first one is simple series clipper having IDR diode. Simple means it is not biased. That means in the circuit itself we will not use any source, that is battery. In the circuit itself we will not use any battery. Whatever the input will be provided, that is the only source of power. Circuit itself does not contain any sort of source, that is called simple. Now series means whenever particular diode, which is the application we are taking, the application as clipper, so particular diode will be in series with load, will have a load resistance across which we will take the output. So the diode and the load resistance will be in series, and we will take the output from the load resistance, that is across the load resistance or parallel to the load resistance, we will take the output. Simple means no inside power source available. Series means diode and resistance so will be in series, and we will take the output from resistance only. We will take the output from resistance, that is the load resistance. It will act as a clipper circuit. That means in that circuit the output will be cut at particular some portion, and we will use ideal diode. That means we will assume, that is whenever one input is forward biased to a diode, current will flow, that is diode is on fully and there is no internal voltage drop inside the diode, that is the ideal case, and there is no resistance also inside the diode. That means no voltage drop will be there inside the diode, no resistance power drop will be there inside the diode. That means generally 0.3 volt for germanium and 0.7 volt for silicon. It is the inbuilt voltage of diode, that is the inbuilt voltage of PN junction, which is opposed. So whenever we apply some input, if the semiconductor diode, that is PN junction, is made of germanium, 0.3 volt drop will be there. Ideal case, I mean practical case, but ideal case we are not taking that one. That means 0.3 volt drop in germanium and 0.7 volt drop in silicon we are not considering. We are assuming the diode as short circuit when it is forward biased. We are assuming the diode as short circuit when it is in forward bias, and we are assuming the diode as open circuit when the diode is in reverse bias. Okay, now we will take our input supply. This is VI across with time. We are plotting the input supply. Now this is Vm and particular this portion is minus Vm. This is zero. So we can see this is a sinusoidal input. It is varying with respect to time. Positive half cycle, negative half cycle. So input voltage is plotted with respect to time. Zero axis. This point is negative maximum voltage, that is minus Vm. This point is positive maximum voltage, that is Vm. This is the input to a clipper circuit, and we will see how the clipper circuit does the operation to cut a particular point to generate the output. First we will do with positive. Positive means positive portion will be cut. Clipper is some portion we have to cut. So positive means positive portion will cut. The circuit is like this. So this is the input, that is Vi, which is applied to the clipper circuit. This is positive terminal, this is negative terminal for applying the input voltage. This is the diode. The portion of the diode you can see at the positive half cycle, that is for this portion. This is reverse biased. At positive half cycle, this is reverse biased. And this is the load resistance, that is R, is the resistance. We will take the output across this. This is the positive polarity of output voltage, this is the negative. So at this two point, that means this point is actually equal to this point, and this point is actually equal to this point. So we are taking actually the output across the resistance. Now the output waveform let us start from the starting of input. Starting of input is 0 volt. Starting of input is 0 volt. That means at this portion voltage is 0. So we can assume this is as short circuit, because at this two point voltage is 0, so there is no voltage. Now if there is no voltage in this total circuit, there is no another source of power present. So that means in the efficiency of at least one power source in this circuit, there is no power source when input supply is 0 volt. So there will be no flow of current in the circuit because there is no source. So output will be 0. That means for 0 input point, output point is 0. Now for positive half cycle, for positive half cycle, this point is positive, this point is negative as given in the board. This diode is reverse bias. If this diode is reverse bias, that means this will act as a open circuit. Diode is reverse bias, this will act as a open circuit. So no current will flow because this is open. So no current will flow in this path. So resistance will have zero current. So voltage across resistance will be 0 into R, that is 0. So there will be no voltage across this resistance. That means we are taking measurement across the resistance, so we will have no output, or our output will be 0 volt for the positive half cycle total. So for positive half cycle total, our from this portion to this portion positive half cycle, our output will be 0 volt. So it will be just this one, that is 0, that is this straight line, this axis it will be. Now for next case is negative half cycle. For negative half cycle, this will be positive, this will be negative. For negative half cycle, the sign will be changed. That means for negative half cycle, this will act as positive, this will act as negative. In that case, we can see this is positive, this is negative. So in that case, we can see the diode is in forward bias. Current can flow in this direction. So in this direction, current can flow because diode is in forward biased. The diode may be assumed as short circuit, current will flow across it. So if this is short circuit, if the diode is acting as short circuit, so whatever this closed loop having only one voltage source, only one resistance, so whatever the voltage source is there, the same voltage will be dropped at here, and this point will be positive, this point will be negative because this is the flow of current. Flow of current is like this. But we are measuring our output, this point as positive, this point as negative. So we are taking negative point to positive and positive point to negative. That means output will have a negative voltage. So this is increasing, this is the peak point, minus Vm, again it is decreasing. So what we will have, we will again have the same thing copied to load resistance in negative direction. So what we will have, the output will be just copy of input negative half cycle. Negative half cycle will be copied as it is in the output, and this maximum negative point will be minus Vm. So this is the positive clipper, that means positive side will be clipped. So we can see our initial waveform was positive half cycle and negative half cycle, and our final waveform we are not having the positive half cycle. The positive half cycle is cutted, only negative half cycle we can see here. So that means positive half cycle is cutted, that's why it is called positive clipper. Next we will have our negative clipper. Negative clipper means the negative portion will be cutted. This is the negative clipper circuit. Input voltage, diode, resistance, output is taken across the resistance. Only difference from the previous circuit is the direction of diode. Previously, direction of diode was in this side, now it is flipped. So we can see the direction of diode is changed. So what we can see, the output as whenever this is the graph, we will plot the output voltage. Whenever we are having the positive half cycle, for positive half cycle this diode is in forward bias, so it will we act as the diode will act as a short circuit. If diode is short circuit, current will flow in this direction, clockwise it will flow. So that means if it is short circuit, input voltage will be simply copied to this resistance, because this voltage will have to be same to this voltage, because there is no other path of current to go, and this is the only voltage drop present in this circuit, assuming this as ideal diode. There is no drop here. So if there is no drop here, whatever the voltage we are applying, same voltage will be copied here. Now this is the direction of flow, that means this point will be positive and this point will be negative, and we are taking the same point as positive, same point as negative, negative to negative, positive to positive. That means the output voltage we will get as positive. Increasing peak point, decreasing, same will be copied to output voltage. So output voltage is a copy of input voltage. Highest point is Vm. Same here. Highest point is Vm. Next, at the negative half cycle, at the negative half cycle the polarity will be reversed. That means this side will be positive, reverse, and this side will be negative. So current tries to flow in this direction, that is from here to here. This is the direction current want to flow, but according to the direction of the diode, it is reverse biased. If it is reverse bias, this will act like a open circuit. If this is a open circuit, current cannot flow in this path. This path we are measuring the output voltage. This path current cannot flow. This is only for measurement. And this is the only loop present in this circuit. And in between the loop, if this is open circuit, that means the circuit is broken. Inside there is a cut, so current cannot flow in the air. That means the flow of current is not possible. Current is zero multiplied by R is zero. That is the voltage drop is zero. So that means at the negative half cycle, output voltage waveform will be zero. So what we just saw for the case of positive flipper, the opposite was the result. And here negative flipper means we have to cut the negative portion. That means this portion is, if we can see, this portion is cut, only positive portion is present. So positive portion is present, negative portion is cut. So this is called negative flipper. And if we add both of positive and negative output, we can have the full waveform. Previously we are having only this, now we are having only this. If both two is added, that is by superimpose, we will have the total input, that is this one. So this is simple series clipper with ideal diode. Now we will see if inside the battery, inside the circuit, any battery is given. If any battery is present inside the circuit, then it is called biased. We will see this operation. So simple is over here. Now our next is biased. Biased series clipper ideal diode. What we'll do? We'll first say for positive, then we'll say for negative. For positive, the circuit, let first draw. This is the biased. Biased means inside the circuit one voltage source is present. That is the biased. Series means we are taking the output from load resistance. This is the output point which is series with diode. Clipper, it will cut some portion. We are assuming ideal diode. Now let us start from zero voltage as input. In input we are having zero voltage. That means this voltage is zero. So we can assume this as short circuit because this amount is zero. This potential at this point that potential at this point is same. Now only source present in this circuit is this battery, and for this the diode is in forward bias. That means current will flow, and as this is the only source present in this closed loop, so that my voltage will drop here, that is voltage V, and the direction is in this way. That means this is positive and this is negative, and we are taking positive and negative here. That means we are taking in opposite direction. That means we have minus V voltage. So this point, suppose we say it is minus V. So for zero input voltage, we are having minus V output voltage. Now as this input grows initially, after zero it goes little bit like this, it is increasing. Now we can see positive and positive is in the same direction. That means these two polarity opposes each other, so we will have our final resultant voltage as subtraction of these two. Now as Vi is increasing sinusoidally little bit from zero, V minus Vi will be more less in magnitude, and that will be following through R. We are taking in opposite direction. That means the magnitude will be less and still it is in negative direction. That means sinusoidally it is increasing, so it will increase sinusoidally. This is very small, it may be look like straight line, but it is sinusoidally, because this is fixed voltage, this is increasing sinusoidally, so our resultant will be varying sinusoidally. This is the point where Vi and V are equal, both are equal and opposite. So at this point output is zero, because input voltage is zero, because two source of input voltage is equal and opposite. Now this voltage again increases in this portion, it again increases, and it increases beyond V. It increases beyond V. So now our resultant Vi is higher, so the polarity of Vi will be dominated. Now if the polarity of Vi is dominated, that means the diode is now in reverse bias. If the diode is in reverse bias, it is assumed to be open. If the diode is open, so current cannot flow here. So without any current, the output voltage will be zero. This continues up to the portion when again Vi is equal to V. When again Vi is equal to V. So for up to that portion, that is from this point to this point, total this portion of this positive half cycle, that is from this to this, up to this point the voltage will be zero. The voltage will be zero because Vi is more, so resultant is reverse bias, it is open, so no current is flowing. That means without the flow of current, it is open circuit, there is no output voltage because zero current multiplied by resistance R will be zero voltage drop at here that we are taking at the output. So up to this point, that is this saturated voltage increase and decrease, up to this point we are having zero voltage, so this point will be zero. This is the axis, this axis will be the output voltage, so output voltage at this time will be zero only. After that, this is the portion where Vi and V both are equal and opposite, so it is zero. Then at this portion, when Vi decreasing beyond V, Vi is less, so resultant will be at the polarity of V, so this will be the direction flow of current. So diode will be in forward bias, and if diode is in forward bias, whatever the voltage that is resultant of subtraction of these two will be here. Now V is fixed and this Vi is decreasing, so V minus Vi will be decreasing. Vi is decreasing sinusoidally, so V is fixed and V minus Vi will be sinusoidally decreasing, and the direction will be in this direction, so we are taking the output. This is the positive point, this is the negative point, but flow is in this direction. By the direction of flow, this is the positive and this is the negative, so we are taking oppositely, so our output will be negative. And as Vi is decreasing sinusoidally, so V minus Vi will be more and more higher as Vi is decreasing. Magnitude will be high, it is taken in negative direction, so it will be negative and magnitude will be high. That means sinusoidally this will be the graph. So this is the graph increasing sinusoidally, this portion is zero, this is the sinusoidally decreasing, this is sinusoidally decreasing. Now after that, in negative half cycle, this will be positive, this will be negative, that is reverse. So now negative positive, negative positive, so both these source will be additive, they are in the same direction, so both will be forward bias, so current will flow, and addition is V plus Vi, V is fixed, Vi will increase in the negative direction sinusoidally and decrease in the negative direction sinusoidally. That means from here we will have a full negative half cycle, and as we are taking in the opposite direction, current flow is in this direction, we are taking in the opposite direction, so it will be negative. That means our this will be from here to here, that is if we take the minus V point, from here to here this is the negative half cycle as it is, from this point to this point. Again at this point, that is after this point, this is the point when our next cycle is there, so again we will have this one like this. So this is the total output waveform. Next, we will go to the negative portion. Okay, one thing, this point, as we can see from minus V, this is the negative half cycle, so this point will be minus of V plus Vm, addition of both of these. Now we can see some portion of positive half cycle, not the total, some portion of positive half cycle is clipped and our axis, that is this zero axis, is down by minus V. This zero axis, input zero axis, is now minus V. So this is the cycle, so this is the cycle and this portion is clipped, so this is biased positive clipper. Now coming to the negative this is the circuit for negative biased clipping. Now we can see the battery polarity is same, only the diode polarity is changed. Now we'll see if input is at this point, that is zero. So this is zero. Because of this, diode is reverse biased, open circuit, no current will flow. That means at zero input, output voltage is zero. When at this portion, little bit input voltage is increasing, at this portion little bit input voltage is increasing, so for Vi is increasing, but it is not yet up to V, so the polarity of V will be the final polarity, and that is reverse bias. That means no current will flow, diode is open circuit and output voltage is zero. That means up to this portion, up to V point, that is this much time portion, the output is, for this much time portion, output is still zero, because input Vi is less than V and V is reverse biasing this diode. Now when Vi will increase beyond V, Vi will increase beyond V, then Vi will make the diode as forward biased. That is, from this portion to this portion, from this portion to this portion, starting from this portion, increasing, again decreasing, so this total portion Vi is more than V, that means it is forward biasing the diode, so diode will conduct and current will flow in this direction, So this part will be positive, same we are taking positive here. So that means we have a copy of input to the output, but not the full positive half cycle, only from here to here. That means only the top of the positive portion we will have here. For this portion means whenever Vi is less than V, Vi again decreases less than V. So V will do what? V will do it reverse bias. So diode will be open, that means current will not flow. So again this point output is zero. In negative half cycle this is negative, this is positive, so both the polarity of Vi and V in negative half cycle will be same, that means they will be additive in nature, so both will make the diode reverse biased, that means diode will be open for the whole negative half cycle and output to the whole negative half cycle will be zero. So this is the output for negative clipper, negative bias clipper. Now we can see this is the output for positive, this is the output for negative. So if we add this one here, we will have total input voltage waveform. So that means here also the axis is down by minus V. Whatever our zero axis for input voltage, same axis is down by minus V, and only this is the waveform, and only above zero the portion is visible in the output. Here only the below zero portion, below zero that is negative portion of waveform is visible. Here only the above zero that is positive side is visible, and as the axis is down by minus V in both cases, because the polarity of battery is not changed, polarity is same. So polarity of battery is subtractive, that is it is opposite of the polarity of Vi. So it has down the axis, so this zero axis has down by minus V, down by minus V, and because of this diode positive portion is clipped. So this is the waveform, positive portion is clipped, only negative portion is visible. This is negative portion is clipped, only positive portion is visible. So this is the waveform and only the positive portion is visible, negative portion is clipped. Next, we will have another circuit. this point, as we say, down by minus V. So output peak point would be Vm minus V. Next we are taking this circuit. So what we can see, this circuit, diode is in same direction, that means it is also positive clipping, that means positive portion will be cut. Only the thing is, the polarity of battery is reversed. Polarity is in the format of additive with VI. If both are additive, that means we can say in this case our output axis was down by minus V. Now this will be up by V, and only the negative portion will be visible. But we'll see point by point. When input is 0 volt, because of this is short circuit, assume potential difference between these two points is 0. Because of this voltage only, this diode is in reverse bias, so output is 0. When it is in the positive half cycle, full we can take, because in positive half cycle these are additive and both are making as reverse bias. So that means for total positive half cycle we are having 0 output voltage. Now in negative half cycle, up to this point, that means when Vi is reverse biased, I mean Vi is polarity is opposite in negative half cycle, so Vi will, now this point is positive, this is the circuit, this point is positive, this point is negative, so Vi will try to forward bias the diode. But if value of Vi is less than V, that is this portion, again V is high, that means diode is open circuit, no current will flow. So after that also, up to this point, no current will flow. When Vi is in negative half cycle and this is the portion, that means the value of Vi is higher than V, value of Vi is higher than V, then only it is making this diode forward bias and current is flowing in this direction, because Vi is reverse bias, Vi is negative half cycle, so it is reversed in polarity, so current will flow in this direction. It is sinusoidally. We are taking this point positive, this point negative, that is opposite we are taking. So our output will have in negative direction. That means it will be like this. That means our output peak point has been reduced by V. So this is minus Vm minus V. So Vm minus V is the magnitude. Vm minus V. V is reduced from Vi. And highest portion of Vi is Vm. So Vm minus V is the magnitude, and it is in negative, that means minus Vm minus V. So what we are having, that our axis is up by V, and only here axis was down by minus V, Here axis is up by V. Diode polarity is not changed. Only the negative was visible. Only the negative is visible. This is the portion. So this is positive half cycle. This is negative half cycle. Only below zero it is visible. Now we will take one circuit for this, and what we will take, we will reverse the battery polarity. That means for negative we are taking battery polarity, we are taking like this one, that is opposite of this one. So battery polarity is additive. If it is additive, it will be high by V. Let us take the zero point as the starting point, zero point of input voltage. Only V is present. It will make the diode as forward bias. So only current is due to this V voltage. So at zero point, our output is V. At zero input, our output is V. Then for our positive half cycle, total positive half cycle we can take because both are additive. Current will flow, diode is in forward bias. So from V point, positive half cycle we can draw as it is. In negative half cycle, this point VI polarity is opposite, but V is still high, so it will be reduced, but due to V it will still conducting, so it is like this. Then when at this portion, when VI is high, VI is higher than V, so it will make this reverse bias. That means it will be open circuit, no current will flow, output voltage will be zero. This portion output voltage will be zero. And whenever at this portion, when it is again less than V, we will have again current flow like this. So what we are getting, the peak point is Vm plus V. This peak point is Vm plus V, and our axis is high by V. Only positive portion is visible, negative portion is clipped. So now if we add this waveform with this waveform, we will have the total input waveform. So this is the activity of clipper, how a particular portion of an input waveform is cutted or clipped, and if we can increase or decrease the axis by inserting a voltage in the circuit in positive direction or negative direction, this is the clipper circuit activity. Thank you.